Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us this edition of Leak Project. I am your host, Rex Bear, and we have a real treat for you, folks. We've got Alexandra Meadors with us, a radio show host, FE specialist, alchemist, intuitive, energy worker, Reiki master, and the list could go on for the entire show. I mean, quite the resume. She is a creator of a popular website and blog at galacticconnection.com, committed to bridging spiritual consciousness with cosmic awareness. On fire to prepare and shift global perspectives gracefully, respectfully, and galactically. Now, Alexandra's focus is to connect minds and hearts everywhere to step out of the 3D matrix unilaterally by bringing forth the cutting-edge implant removal process, soul alignment, and DNA activation. She contributes an authentic freedom and effective unplugging from the matrix we now reside. It's so great to have you on the show with us tonight here at the Leak Project, Alexandra. How the heck are you?
Really good. Really good. Actually, I experienced a healing yesterday and it was magnificent.
Oh, fantastic. How'd that work?
Well, I just felt like I really needed to release a lot of stuff because I do a lot of planetary holding of the space, so to speak. And I really needed to release because the energies are so intense right now.
Oh, yeah. I mean, absolutely. With all the stuff that's going on, we certainly live in incredible times, either on the cusp of something brilliant or could be the exact opposite. And I'm certainly going for the brilliant aspect of things.
Definitely.
Now, obviously, you've been doing work for years. I mean, you're certainly a legend in many fields and genres that you touch. And I'm hoping that for those that maybe haven't heard of you before, because we reach such a wide variety of people, all of them are very well-educated and astute listeners. But tell them a little bit about yourself, just a quick description, and we'll segue from there, please.
Well, do you want me to go back or just current?
Well, I mean, if we could go, I know that you had a car accident many years ago that kind of turned a switch on for you, didn't it? It was really a big, okay, maybe we could start from there.
Okay. I was coming back from work on a Saturday afternoon and I was warned three times and I didn't listen to my guidance and I had a horrible car accident. And what it ended up causing me to do is just sit in bed. I was in so much pain, had an extensive amount of injuries and soft tissue damage. Basically, you know, head to toe. I had a concussion. I had dislocations all over the place. I had sprained back and messed up vertebrae, and my neck was completely foobarred. And I completely shattered my foot. And so, you know, mobility was not an option. Let's just put it that way. So I laid on my back, freaking out. Just, you know, because I've always been somebody who's, I've always got something to do, basically.
Right.
I think people know that about me. And I'm lying on my back and I said, oh my God, why is this happening? What is this about? And I knew this was just so prolific, you know, that just the way it happened, the manner in which it happened. And that experience alone, it not only taught me how to love my pain, which sounds crazy, it caused me to go down a path of amazing alternative healing modalities and therapies, which now I'm thoroughly involved in because I saw the results. I'm truly someone who can come from testimony with that which I use on others. And I felt very, very married to that concept. I wanted to be somebody who could say, I use this, I know this works. I was very aware of the healing that's needed on the planet. And what happened was lying in bed, started getting a ton of information. And the information basically was showing me the direction in which I'm going to be going. And the main thing was a very massive project was presented to me that I was supposed to be spearheading. And we're kind of working towards that, frankly, Rex, okay, because it's that massive and it requires a substantial amount of funding. But it's been just following the cookie crumbs, you know, not everything is always totally visible right up front. It's really a journey. It taught me to be a lot more patient. And absolutely, I got just so in bliss with my connection with Source and a lot of guidance. I had some incredibly wild experiences while I was in bed too. So
now, did you have a near-death experience as well? Did you go to the other side or anything like that when you got into that accident?
I know I died, but I don't remember it. I know that sounds crazy, but I know I died, but I wasn't out for that long a period of time.
Okay.
But I knew I had too much to do. And this was all part of you know, from what I've received now, this was all part of getting me back on track. It was kind of like a wake up call, you know, and boy, did it wake me up in a big way.
That was more than a slap in the face. I mean, that was a, yeah. You know, I mean, break all your, my goodness. I mean, I'm thinking, it was funny you said that because I was actually thinking when you were talking about that, and my gut was telling me that was universe kind of pushing you back into your, you know, specific orbit that you need to be in to create whatever it was that you were designed for. I don't know. I mean, that's just kind of what came into my mind when you were talking about that. And then you just said that afterwards. That's incredible. So it's actually made you.
You hit it right on the head. That's exactly why. I mean, I spent a little bit of time. I'm not someone who remained in victimhood at all. In fact, I used to blow people away because I was averaging 7 doctor's appointments a week. And everything from a neurologist, because my head, I had significant head injury, and, you know, everything from chiropractor to neurologist to, you know, you name it. I mean, it was just across the board. And everybody, the doctors were saying to me, how are you maintaining? We can't believe the amount of pain you're in. How are you getting through this? And I said, because I know there's a purpose. And when I would sit in the waiting room for my appointment and I saw all these really crippled and hurt people, you know, obviously sitting in the waiting room with me, I would take that time to inspire them and try to help them. So that's incredible. Actually saw that as part of my journey.
Well, yeah. I've often heard if you have a purpose, whatever obstacles present themselves in your life, just knowing that you have a purpose and you're following that path, you can get through anything. And certainly you're living proof of that. I think that that's incredible and outstanding. And one of the things that I wanted to bring up is here at the Leak Project, as I mentioned at the beginning, we have so many different listeners that have certain spiritual beliefs, religious beliefs. You know, I mean, I talk to so many great people everywhere from, you know, Paul Beegley, where he's a really nice Christian person that has many followers as far as the work that he does and the teachings with the Bible. And then I talk to people that are on the opposite side of the spectrum where they either don't have any religious beliefs. Some, I've talked to people that are atheists and agnostics and Gnostics and truth seekers and people that study hermetics. And with all of that said, the reason I'm bringing this up is because sometimes I read comments from people when I interview others that don't have the same religious beliefs, and they'll come out attacking them or saying that they're satanic or witchcraft or it's new age, when a lot of times, from the research that I've done anyway, these alternative fields of health, energy work, some of the work that you do and others that call new age and fringe, that might have that fundamentalist approach on religion. What happens is, from the work that I've done and the research that I've done, the stuff that you do has been around far longer oftentimes than some of these religions, like the Abrahamic type religions. They were around in the Sumerian times, even all the way back to ancient Atlantis. Isn't that correct?
Yes, yes, and beyond. I mean, you have to really take a look at this world. Look at how ridiculous everything is run. And if you truly believe in a omnipresent, omniscient source, some sort of higher power. I think we all agree on that. Even the agnostics, they still tend to, they know that there's some sort of force in the universe. And so we all are really on the same page. And unfortunately, religion was designed to create schisms and separation amongst humanity. We are at a time right now where we're being called to at least allow others and accept that others, and accept that others have different ways of seeing life and become a little bit more compassionate and reasonable in allowing people to express themselves. This is what we mean by becoming more of a galactic community, you know, having more of a galactic lens. With my blog, I deliberately present information that I can actually give 2 different articles with opposing views of the same topic. And the reason for that is I believe you are the master. You are the one that will be able to read and pull out what is needed, because everything within you is divinity. Everything, you know, your soul spark is divine, and you have a divine path. So the ancientness, in my opinion, we're just repeating that again. I mean, we're really, you know, the universe is made up of cycles. So are we. So are our seasons. Everything is a cycle. Right. And we are just merely replaying a cycle again. This time, we're going to get it right.
Yeah, I certainly hope so. It's that Groundhog Day movie that comes to mind, right? You got to keep going and doing it again and again and again until you hit it just right. And then, yeah, it's the next day. So
True.
Now, let me ask you, with a lot of the stuff you've got on your website, I mean, just a gourmet buffet of intel on here, everything from implant removals to soul alignments, DNA activation, galactic wave technologies, and I definitely want to get into these. The first thing I was hoping we could discuss is the implant removal process and how you say to unplug from the matrix. Now, I know people that think they've got microchips and implants, and then there's this really strange phenomenon going on called the black goo, which supposedly has been spread in the Gulf Coast and in chemtrails, and you've got Morgellons and all sorts of other nasties out there. So do you feel that everybody has some type of implant? Let's talk about the implants and such. What is your thought process?
There's no question in my mind that in order to be in this reality, we actually agreed to be implanted. And if we didn't agree to it, we were well aware that we were going to have to go through that process in order to incarnate here. My feeling is that there is a massive number of star seeds on this planet who have come here to assist in what I call the ascension mission. It's actually a descension mission, but anyway. And because of that, we've had to really step down in our frequencies in order to assist the human race. And one of those pieces is taking on implants. Now, a lot of people, they think of Lear, Dr. Lear, who was very well known for removing physical extraterrestrial implants, probably the only person in his field that could do it successfully at that time. The type of implants that we deal with are on an etheric level. And when you get into an etheric level type of implant, people's eyes gloss over if they're not familiar with this topic. And I can tell you they're just as real as a physical, to the point where when they're removed, you will wake up the next day and you can either be extremely blissed out, feeling freer than you've ever felt in your lifetime, and you can be sore where they've been removed from. And we provide essences and oils to assist you through that entire process. No one does what Galactic Connection does. I am a huge proponent to support all the healers on the planet. And as you said before, to stop the nonsense of creating the healers into some sort of possible, black magic or, witches or what have you, kind of labeling them into something that they really are not. The healers, in my opinion, are the future of bringing this whole planet to a place of equality and stability and healing and harmony. It's so important. Now, the part that we do is very, very unique. And Galactic Connection was given a very specific role and a very specific decree and permission. This is a full-blown cosmic operation, believe it or not. It is very major. It's done on every planet. And our planet is basically known as one of the worst as far as oppression and implanting and programming. The way these implants work is they will send you, they'll send you thought forms. So, for example, if you really want to go see a friend that you're in love with, let's say it's a girlfriend, and you really want to kind of tie the knot with this woman, and you start getting messages and you just feel really good about it. She really respects you, honors you. It's just like the most amazing connection you've ever had. And you start getting doubts and you start feeling, and you start kind of hearing things like, you know what, she's not going to like me. Or, you know what, she's not going to really care. We usually toss that up to, oh, that's my own negative self-talk. But in fact, it's also involved with implants. And they're designed to thwart us in the direction that's going to either bring us joy or bring us back in alignment with the galactic or global missions that we have. When you remove an implant, the average number of implants that we remove from each individual that comes through is usually at least 14. And they are normally lodged in areas of the brain, the neck, down the spine. We also find them in various organs. And we do a thorough scan. What is unique is that I provide very specific encodements, as does Jerry. These encodements are like, they're like information packs. They're like keys to a lock. And those individuals may not understand them at that moment, but they will be necessary for them to finish or start the operation that they came here to do. So implants, in my opinion, it is a very realistic thing. More and more people are taking a look at them. More and more people are talking about them. There isn't a person on the planet that has incarnated on this planet up until a certain year some of the children are not being implanted, and this has something to do with their soul families and their star families. But pretty much most of the people on the planet have been implanted.
Okay.
And you don't show up here. You just don't make it here unless you're implanted. And that's part of the dark agenda, so that they can monitor you. The other thing I wanted to say, Rex, is implants act as transmitters and receivers. So they are literally using us to be online with a digital off-world system so that they can monitor what we do, what we feel, what we think. And this is actually very biblical too, but those that run the planet that are demonic, that are very dark, they thrive off of what's called ectoplasma, which is created when you go into a state of fear. Exactly. It's very real. Hollywood, a lot of the stuff that Hollywood puts out, other than the fear porn, is very real. Okay. But ectoplasma is their food source. So they want us, they prefer the human race, anybody who's in a human body, they prefer us to stay in a condition of fear, rage, discomfort, dissatisfaction, because they live off that energy. They're a parasite.
I've thought that so many times before and often wondered if there's these ethereal parasites that just feed off of people's fighting, fear, anger.
Yes.
And that's why maybe this globe, as the way that it is turning right now, if you look at the, I don't know, just the overall archetype of, geez, there's this pain and suffering around the globe, and all of these incredible inventions and opportunities get suppressed by bigger monies and, you know, bigger corporations, these megacorps that just seem to purchase all of these good ideas. They lock it away in their vaults, and then they slowly release, you know, little sweet poisons and gems of destruction to kind of create this idiocracy type mass. And it's really unfortunate, but there are people I've noticed that are really breaking out of it, even with all of the suppression, and they're almost becoming superhuman at a mental level, at a spiritual level, because they seem to kind of stay out of the destruction and harm's way, even though they should probably have it right in front of them. Something's protecting them.
Very true. And you are less of a puppet for the dark agenda when you remove your implants. Now, we do say the implant process because we have found, and we were given, you know, divine decree given this process. This was literally very well planned out, and it's an entire operation. But it's not just enough to remove the implants. The other part that we do is we actually align the soul. It's different than fragmentation. Yes, we do work on the fragmenting of the soul. And if you're not familiar with that, every time that we have a major trauma or a major loss in our lives or any kind of major moment where we just feel like we failed, in many cases, or a car accident like my own, in many cases, we will lose a piece of our soul. Now, for those that aren't familiar with this, it is very, very true that when you hit major impact, when your body in a car accident hits like a wall, the body is more than just the physical body. This is where everything gets complicated and convoluted between the different religions, is when will people start recognizing that we're more than just a physical body? It's already proven. There's so much information to prove it. So when you are hit, like let's say you're in a car and you hit a wall, the etheric part of your body, which it's almost like Russian dolls. So you have your physical body, you have your emotional body, your mental body, your spiritual body, you have your causal body. There's all these bodies around the physical body. They're energetic bodies. And that's why many people say that we are an energetic body in a physical vessel rather than the other way around. So when something drastic happens to us, it reacts, and it's almost like the waves of a bomb going off in our energetic field. And it really disturbs a lot of stuff. It just disturbs a lot of our energetic cohesion. And so we're working on those fields, and we have found most alternative, even doctors, practitioners, they will tell you hands down that the most effective way to address the body is top down, to address the body from the higher etheric bodies, not just the physical body. This is why Western medicine fails almost all the time, unless it's something that's traumatic, like a leg cut off or something like that.
Right.
So it's very important. You know, you need to address the soul, because when you have something very drastic happen to you, which we have, I'm a very firm believer, and I wasn't before. I was brought up Roman Catholic. You know, I very much believe now that we are an amalgamation of a lot of different lifetimes. We've had past lives, which you use the word past with parentheses. And because of that, we have carried through our DNA a tremendous amount of trauma, bloodshed, war, grief, sorrow. And this is what we do in the second and third processes. We kind of get into that area, try to get them restabilized, get the soul back where it belongs. We've even been shown that in some cases the implants are so destructive to the physical body. They literally will send frequencies around specific organs and cause the individual to get sick. We have found that if that happens, in many cases, that particular organ was something that was devastatingly injured, like in a battle in a prior lifetime. And removing the implants is like a really great step. I've had people that have instantaneously lost any kind of illness that they carried from the time they were a child, you know. So it's really major. I mean, there's something to this, right? I mean, and then we go into the DNA sequencing, and we're very, very, very adamant about bringing each individual back to their human angelic blueprint. That's the most important thing.
Now, if we could jump into the implants, like how would somebody find these astral implants? Because I'm thinking of the radionics machines that were created that are just incredible. Some of the digital
Have
ones,
one.
you know, not ones that you put together with a shoebox and a couple of wires and a couple of dials and stuff. But I've seen some pretty neat ones, how they can actually target in on people remotely if you give them the information and see what that person's aura looks like, diagnose their blood and everything else. It's pretty amazing. Now, I don't know all the details and if it's, you know, some type of really cool, I guess you could say magic trick where it's not really real, but it seemed pretty accurate from some of the stuff that I've done research on. Now, how do you find those chips or how do you find those implants astrally?
Honestly, I am not that good about seeing them, and there's not that many people that can find them. It's a special gift. You have to have a special clairvoyance, and there's a reason for that. And the reason is to protect you, the individual, because if people go in and they start monkeying around with your implants and they don't know what they're doing, it can be fairly serious. So we basically scan you. I work with a couple of different healers. One is Jerry Yusko, and he's just excellent at this. This is one of the main things he came here to do, was to help people and assist them in being freed from it. Now, you brought up radionics. I have two different systems, by the way, that we work with. One of them is based on reviewing the DNA, and it's through radionics. And it's a very legitimate tool. It's one in which I used to gain my health and strength back from the car accident. And it works. And it's based on frequency. Just about everything in this planet, on this planet, within this planet, and above this planet, it has to do with frequency. So radionics is incredibly successful when you know what you're doing and how you can focus the right frequencies to an individual. For example, if you came to me and said, "I have a bladder infection," a Western medical doctor will typically say, "Oh, we need to check out your kidneys," or, "We need to check out your bladder." But alternative practitioners know that in many instances, that's not where the issue is. So you need to go deeper and go to the root of the issue. Implants are definitely the seed to all dis-ease, in my opinion, period.
Now, who made these implants? Why are we here then? I mean, is there like a kind of like that movie Jupiter Ascending, I guess, from the Wachovia brothers? They're now the Wachovia sisters, I think, because they both recently, No, really, they have. And that's interesting. I mean, once again, folks, I don't care what you're, you know, if you guys want to do whatever you want, that's totally cool. I just think it's interesting that two amazing people that come out with one of the most fascinating movies of all time, the Wachovia brothers, are now the Wachovia sisters, and this is after that whole Kris Jenner thing and stuff. And you know, I'm really open-minded. I just wonder if this is kind of all a part of a process to keep people confused, or you've got the transhuman movement now.
It's totally that. It's
Okay.
totally that. The purpose of the whole thing is to keep us from really coming into a state of balance between the divine masculine and the divine feminine. No question about it. And Hollywood is used on a regular basis to keep that confusion alive. And, you know, I have many gay friends myself. I love them dearly. But, you know, the fact of the matter is, when you have stories like Bruce Jenner, you have to step back and say, what's really going on here? Hollywood and that whole sector of the population is mind controlled. And they are used, unfortunately, I mean, that's a huge generalization. I'm not going to say every single person, but that industry is used to control minds. It's used to control minds. And we talk all the time about how frequencies and subliminal messages are being shared on the television. But the individuals that they're using to play that part, they're also part of that mind control.
Right. There, you know, once again, the MK Ultra special, you go back to when they started compartmentalizing people based upon shock factors, just freaking them out so bad that they create another personality in their mind because they can't control or handle the how much, you know, how freaked out they're getting from this stuff. So now they've, in my opinion, taken that technology and refined it to just this science where they can put it on the TV and the movies and Hollywood and show these special effects and script lines and have certain sounds and objects at specific times to create this subconscious programming. And it's interesting how many people watch TV to go to sleep now with all these commercials that are pushing these pharmaceutical drugs and stuff into their subconscious. That could be another possibility of just keeping the masses under this mind control.
Well, and they, you know, everything's based on sound, right? So you're getting back to frequency.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And it's absolutely proven that there are frequencies that are being distributed through, I'm not just going to pick on the TV, you know, I mean, through many, many things. I mean, you look around us now, we have, everything is smart technology. We have chemtrails. We have, you know, even the lights at a four-way stop have these devices now that are sending out either low or high grade frequencies. And they used all of the men and women in each of the wars as guinea pigs to determine how the body is affected. World War II was one of that was one of the primary roles of World War II and the concentration camps was to do massive amounts of research on the body to know what they could do to control the minds. If anybody thinks our government is our friend, look up what government means. It means mind control.
Mind control and suppression of liberty.
But I mean, government means mind control.
Yeah, I mean, breaking it down to that, that certainly should make people think, what is going on here? Now, so ETs made us, is that your...
No, okay. Not at all. I do not believe that the Anunnaki made us. I think that's propaganda.
Okay.
I think that was deliberately put out there to confuse our community. I believe that I was created by my creator, you know, period, as was everyone else. The extraterrestrials, yes, they're geneticists, and yes, they do a lot of hybridization, and yes, people are created that way, but in my estimate, I would never take away that which is the reign of God himself.
Nice. So, the divine providence, absolutely. And doesn't the word God even mean unknown?
Yes, it does. And that's why, I mean, and it really is, you know, I mean, you've got the Christian population who kind of perceive it as a being like, you know, a man or whatever. And you've got all these other different populations who perceive it as maybe a cloud or maybe it's the essence of nature or, you know, what have you. It doesn't really matter, folks. I mean, when we stop getting so hung up on what we feel and believe has to be what you feel and believe, when we stop doing that, this world will radically change.
Think that we're on the cusp of something great right now?
Oh, I don't think it. I know it. I mean, we are in the midst right now. If you look at all of the headlines on galacticconnection.com's blog, you know, like today's information was just fascinating to me because you've got major whistleblowers stepping up. Now, many people will tell you this is the first time in a very, 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 very long time that we have had people successfully tell their story and blow the whistle on very large agencies and still be alive. That is divine providence right there. Okay.
You know, certainly you would think so because many years ago or even just 10 years ago, that might not fly. But how about these people that are in Hollywood and come out and talk against the system, then a few weeks later, a year later, 6 months later, they have these mysterious deaths, and you know, they get heart attacked or they die in the elevator that they wrote a song about many years ago, saying that they were suppressed with the slave system of the music industries. I'm referring to Prince right now. It's just, it's remarkable.
Absolutely. I really loved Prince's music too. You cannot, and this has come out, it's been very, very, actually there's been a lot of whistleblowers regarding this. You cannot get in full-fledged into Hollywood and be in movies and be very high profile without signing specific contracts with the dark agenda. Now they think they're signing it with United Artists or whatever records, Tower Records or whoever. They think they're signing with MGM or you know, some big, huge company or corporation. But in fact, what they are is they're signing their soul away to the dark agenda that runs the planet. And anybody, I don't care what your thoughts are, or what your belief system is as far as your spirituality, it does not take a lot to understand and see that there's something very, very diabolical running this planet. And if you research and stop putting your head in the sand and you look at all the different ways that they're trying to literally poison the population, you will say to yourself, man, these are not our friends. And yet we've given them full authority. So yeah, you bet we're in an amazing time right now. We are coming to terms. The entire human populace is coming to terms with their own sense of authority. That's the biggie right now, is really understanding what that word means, what it involves, how we are not stepping into our authority. And if all of us made that decision together as one, all the stuff would stop. But because we've been kind of acquiescent about the kinds of things that have been going down, and rightfully, understandably so, because a lot of people have been scared and assassinated and their families have been destroyed and, you know, all that stuff. I mean, look at the people that signed the Declaration of Independence, for God's sakes.
Right.
They were annihilated for what they did. But
well,
they knew.
They annihilated the people here before them. You know, I mean, look at the natives. They've been systematically destroyed around the globe. And it seems like something's trying to just get rid of any ancient knowledge of being connected to source and the planet, nature, you know, spirits, everything. It just, there's this suppression that I've just read about for so many years, and I can feel it in my gut as well, that there's something out there that certainly doesn't have our best interests at heart. I've said that many times. And one thing that I'm wondering about too is if they wanted to, and when I say they, I'm referring to those that control the strings, the defense contractors, the military industrial complex, Hollywood, the pharmaceutical companies, these, you know, there's basically six corporations at the top levels that control virtually all the science, all the media, all the news, practically everything. And what's interesting is I talked about this stuff before the internet was even out there. When I was just a little kid, for some reason, I just knew this. And I'm having the opportunity to speak with you, Alexandra, and others that are just so well educated in so many fields. And I just applaud what you do with your website, your blogging, your work, galacticconnections.com. Just so much good stuff out there. But who are these archons? Who puts these implants in the astral realms when we come here? I mean, what did we have to sign up with here to be here?
Good question. Okay. Because there's a lot of, you know, what I'm going to share with you is either my own messages or information I've compiled from other people. I mean, we've done thousands upon thousands of these across the world in all different countries, and we receive emails from all of these people. So I've been able to compile some of the information that they have gleaned, as well as whatever I've read or watched on the internet, you know. It has become very apparent that the reptilians, the draconians, the Anunnaki, who apparently have changed sides, apparently they have seen the error of their ways and they are now trying to assist in bringing freedom to this planet. The problem is that the reptilians, and there are higher commanders and higher up hierarchies of that force. Not all reptilians are bad, by the way. Again, we need to stop being so polar in the way that we see things. But this general league of beings, they set up an entire fence. It's some sort of net that is a digital net around planet Earth. They also did it around Mars. They did it around the moon. And what this fence does is it basically lets them know if any ships are coming into the area that are benevolent, that are actually wanting to help humanity. Okay. Now, they not only set up that net, which was, we're talking super beyond our brain as far as our 3D conscious reality for us to comprehend this, but these are very technologically savvy individuals who have access to this kind of data on higher dimensional planes. So, and this is off world. It's not necessarily residing on planet Earth.
You think it's the dark side of the moon?
Oh, the dark side of the moon, in my opinion, is it. They would never want us to see it because it would be disclosure. You know, it would show that there have been giants, there have been other different types of beings and extraterrestrials, etc., and they would never be able to explain it away.
Have you heard of the Soul Cube?
I have.
I think it was John Lear that talked about that, where they did some remote viewing when somebody died in a car accident and they followed the soul to some location on the moon. So he brought up the Soul Cube on the moon. Do you think there might be some validity to that?
Yes. Yes. And the cube represents the Saturnian lifestyle. It represents the box in which they want us to remain in. It represents keeping us imprisoned. And when you see cube-like ships, you can pretty much bet they're not of the light.
The Borg cube.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, even you go to the Star Trek and the, you know, what they portray in the movies, and you look at the, let's go back to the movie Hellraiser. Do you remember that? I'm not a big horror film guy.
I never watched that movie. I just don't like those kind of movies.
You know, I don't either, but they came out in the early 80s, and I was a little kid at the time, you know, so that was just really cool to me, watching Pinhead and the Cenobites and all that stuff. But I'm only bringing that up because they have this cube, this box, and the box it's a puzzle that opens up hell. And it seems like, like you said, they always use a box or a cube or something to represent imprisonment, the dark side, assimilation. That's very interesting. I'm glad you brought that up.
Well, on top of that, this is really interesting. Some people may not have heard this already. If you take a cube and you unfold a cube, let's say it's a piece of paper and it's actually in a box. If you unfold the cube, there's a box, 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 and then two boxes on the left and right. And it ends up being the shape of a cross. It's very interesting.
That's
so
cool.
That can represent many things. That can represent on a metaphysical level, air, thought, and the fact that we're controlled, our thoughts are controlled in many, many occasions. Okay. We run on a lot of programs. I mean, I've done enough mission work to see that with my own two eyes. There are programs after programs after programs that have been created. I mean, ancient programs created to try to keep us oppressed. And these programs are kind of like the programs you load onto your laptop. Except the only difference is they're sending out a frequency and they're run through this net that they use around the planet. And then that is literally being broadcast over and over and over again. But because it's not heard, nobody believes it to be true if you're not studying this kind of stuff. The interesting thing is when you look at the sword, it can represent so many different things. It can represent the masculine. It can also represent justice. But it also represents the way in which we think. And whenever I think of a cube, that's where I go.
You know, and the sword is also used, if you look at hermetics and the occult, that represents, you know, protection from evil spirits and demons. And justice. And then you've got the Excalibur pulling the sword on the stone, being noble and mighty to be able to get that. So you're really hitting on some cool points here. And one of the things that, I mean, I really think makes a lot of sense is these frequencies you speak of, Alexandra, because if you look at the society we live in today and returning veterans and others that have just a real bad rap when they shouldn't, you know, I mean, they went out there and they were doing the best that they could because they wanted to protect the country, and they were forced all these lies and mind control to go out there and fight for what they thought was right, not these corporate wars. And, you know, maybe some people knew that and that's why they got involved, because that's what they wanted to do. And that's fine. I mean, I'm not judging here, but the reason I'm bringing this up is because when they get back from war, you know, they've been used as experiments and guinea pigs and injected with all these just nasty vaccines that who knows what's in them, being exposed to depleted uranium, doing the bidding of these corporations, and just finding all this hate and anger in people on the other side of the world because they occupy that side of the world. And it's really unfortunate. But what I'm wondering is why nothing more serious has happened You know, I mean, you've got 9/11, which was most likely an inside job and a lot of false flags, but has there really ever been anything recent where a disgruntled person went out and did something really, really bad? Not really. I mean, at least that you're not hearing about it on the media. So maybe people stay suppressed. They're angry like that with these frequencies, and that's why nothing ever really serious happens. It's pretty much just, you know, false flag type events, in my opinion, for the most part.
I was going to say a couple of things. Number one, false flags are, it is becoming extremely apparent from those, I honor those that have really buckled down and followed the false flags. I mean, we need more and more people to just focus on these particular topics. And because we need to know, we should know what's going on in our world. But those that have really chased down the Boston bombing, you know, and that type of thing, Columbine, once you really research that, there are so many holes in all of the news. And that leads to the fact that supposedly there has been given a decree. There's some sort of cosmic law or whatever, that there are particular amounts of people, particular people themselves, that cannot be killed. They are not allowed to be killed. I this is literally something that does exist, because if they were to be killed or whatever, if on a galactic scale, it affects not only our planet, but other planets to such a degree, it will not be allowed. Period. And that's why I say in my interviews over and over again, the moment that we step back and see that we're in an absolute radical change on this planet, and yet how much loss of life have we experienced? It has been incredibly low compared to what we would expect. I mean, even when earthquakes and things go off, they will, in many cases, go off in areas where they're not very civilized, or they'll go off at a specific time of the day where it could have been a lot more devastating if it had been a different time of the day. This is not happenstance. Mother Earth is working with us, and we are working with her. This is why the healers of the world need to be honored and need to be acknowledged for the amount of work that they do, because there are many of us holding the space, doing light work, making sure that the planet stays stable. We are working in tandem with her. And she with us. This is not a mission where we're just at a whim with whatever she decides. We work together as a team.
Yeah.
It's a very different way to see things.
Well, and it's a good perspective, because if you look at quantum entanglement and we're all connected at some primordial level, everything is a part of this ocean, yet we're our own individual drops of water. It seems as if you take something from somewhere, then there has to be a reaction somewhere else. And you
yes.
know, life, death, life, you know, up, down. It's the yin, the yang, the opposites. And I guess right now with the evolution where the archetype of man is at, is we have to live in this duality to see the essence of each side. Like you said, you went through this just horrible, horrible pain for so many years. You were on your bed thinking, what am I going to do here? My bones are broken. I'm not used to this. And you embraced your pain and overcame it. Now you can express your ideals and information with the world, which is just beautiful. And so magical in a wonderful way, you know, I mean, giving people hope, and the alternative modules and healing approaches that you use that aren't, associated with most Western medicines. And you've got this just enormous system that controls the medicines now. It's nice that people like you are really getting out there and helping others. How many people do you talk to and help typically a week?
Oh my God. Well, that's kind of hard to answer, because I carry so many hats. I oversee the blogging. I do my own radio show. I make remedies every week, a couple times a week sometimes. I also run the business. I answer gazillions of emails, and I actually have other people answering gazillions of emails. So it's hard to answer that. I can tell you that overall, those that have come through the process, I mean, we're talking thousands. I have not taken the time to finally count it all out, because I don't normally have the time. And it wasn't until about, February that I really made the decision to start kind of pulling back. I was working like 20-hour days, you know, for 4 years.
Wow. Sleep is on the back burner.
And I don't even know, looking back on it, I don't know how I did it, but I did it because I knew I had to. And I you know, I'm not going to use the word sacrifice because I love what I do and I'm honored to be of service to those that decide that they want to come to Galactic Connection. You know, I mean, the most important thing to me is to create a bridge amongst all of the guardians, all of the star seeds, and because they really are the key to the ufology community and the conspiracy community, because in those two communities, you can get really off kilter scientifically and not have that balance of spirituality. And so we are needed on this planet in a big way. There are people that are working so hard and they get no acknowledgement and they don't want it, but they are literally changing the history of our planet and where we're going for the good. So I kind of get, fired up about that because I know many, many, many of them.
Well, you're very fortunate to know them and to be able to work with them.
I am. It's an honor. It's a total honor. And, you know, for whatever reason, I came here to do this work. Everybody pretty much really knows who I am. I say that to them, tap into me on the inner plane. You'll know who I really am. You'll know I'm legitimate and that my intention is pure. There's so much garbage on the internet for anybody that's out there trying to do something good. And there's so much trolling done by our own government agencies to create the confusion, to prevent people from moving forward because they're scared, because they don't know who to trust. They don't know who's going to take advantage of them or going to help them or not help them. And that is totally legitimate. But there are really decent, organizations, enterprises out there that really have their heart in the right place. And they truly want to make this heaven on earth. That's my goal, is to create heaven on earth.
When can people listen to you on your radio shows?
I have radio shows on Tuesday afternoons from 3 to 4:55 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, and that's Station 2. And if they don't catch it on BBS Radio, I have a YouTube channel and a Vimeo channel, plus they can access it on the blog itself.
Great. What's your YouTube channel?
It's youtube.com/Galactic Connection. Okay. And we're still working on that because I'm uploading a lot of interviews from the old days when I was doing audio only.
Nice. Rex. What are you saying? What are you saying?
And so I'm trying to convert those and get those up there because there's just so many more radio shows that I've done that aren't up there right now. So we're working on that. We've got so much going on. I wake up every day and I say, wow, I'm so not only excited because I really do feel that we've had some drastic breakthroughs in the last couple of months. And of course, the last couple of years have been very, very difficult for everyone. You know, we've all been letting go of a lot of stuff. And that sometimes involves losing friends, walking away from family members, breaking up marriages. You know, this is the kind of stuff. There's a lot of upheaval. And that has to happen because we are a microcosm of this macrocosm. We are representing what Earth herself is going through. Don't ever forget that. So if the statistics are showing that the majority of the people on the planet are starting to second guess the government and they're starting to question everything, then you can bet that Mother Earth has a lot to do with that. You can bet that she herself is starting to get fed up, holding the space for all of us to be ready for this process, which is what she's been doing for a long time. And it's one of those things where everything that is happening in our own personal lives, especially at this time, when you heal yourself, you are healing a whole band of frequency of people that are on your same band of frequency. Now, how cool is that?
Oh, that's very cool. And it makes sense, you know, it really does. It kind of reminds me of people that are avid cyclists. You know, I certainly enjoy riding, and people in the Tour de France, they'll get up into the peloton where they've got, you know, 20, 15 people all going at the same speed and they're all in harmony with each other and they're synced together and their vibrational frequencies are all on par and they're one machine working together in harmony. So that's a really cool thing to bring up.
Yeah, it also delves into what I do because I'm an alchemist. And that's an interesting story unto itself, Rex, because you asked me this before. When I was lying in bed, I had always been a corporate person. I was in sales and sales management and really working my buns off. And that was not going to happen anymore. And I was, like you were talking to me before we went on air, I went to a global prosperity group offshore seminar. I met David Icke. I met Frederick Learman, I met Edward Griffin, all these really amazing people, had one-on-one conversations with them, realized in 4 or 5 days that every single thing that I had been taught was a lie, because they showed physical evidence of it at the seminar. My world was so rocked that I came home, and at that point, I had to make a decision, and I knew I just couldn't go back into the corporate world. There was just no way. So when the accident occurred and I was lying in bed, I was like, you know what? It's time for me to step into my healing abilities, because there was so much healing being done to me, so many amazing healers helping me. I wouldn't be where I am today without them. And so I learned an immense amount. And I feel like I received a lot of encodements from very specific people to be doing what I'm doing now. But I kind of woke up. I decided to go back to an alternative school for flower essences and homeopathy, and learned how the body really does heal. You know, it was just completely a different lens than what I had been taught before. And I just started working around the clock. I was obsessed with making remedies. So I had to step back and go, there must be something to this, right? And that led to, I started receiving messages that my alchemy was going to be very important, to give it about a year and a half. And then everything started happening. And then the implant removal process came forth. The implant removal process is also an initiation with my essences and oils. It's a whole process. And it's all done on the inner plane. You're completely involved.
That's great. Well, I've got to say, Alexandra, it's been just a real pleasure to speak with you. I hope that we can have the opportunity to talk again sometime. And I'd also like to recommend that our listeners check out her work. I mean, just an amazing gourmet buffet here, you guys. GalacticConnection.com. Everything from articles, podcasts, healing modalities, you name it, it's there. I mean, just a lot of important information. So this has been wonderful. Thank you so much for joining us, Alexandra.
Thank you, Rex, for having me. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. You guys take care and know that we are sending you love all the time.
Wonderful. Well, this is great. Take care. And folks, it's been great to speak with you. Be the change you want to see. This is Rex Bear. Good night. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us this edition of Leak Project. I am your host, Rex Bear, and we have a real treat for you, folks. We've got Alexandra Meadors with us, a radio show host, FE specialist, alchemist, intuitive, energy worker, Reiki master, and the list could go on for the entire show. I mean, quite the resume. She is a creator of a popular website and blog at galacticconnection.com, committed to bridging spiritual consciousness with cosmic awareness. On fire to prepare and shift global perspectives gracefully, respectfully, and galactically. Now, Alexandra's focus is to connect minds and hearts everywhere to step out of the 3D matrix unilaterally by bringing forth the cutting-edge implant removal process, soul alignment, and DNA activation. She contributes an authentic freedom and effective unplugging from the matrix we now reside. It's so great to have you on the show with us tonight here at the Leak Project, Alexandra. How the heck are you?
Really good. Really good. Actually, I experienced a healing yesterday and it was magnificent.
Oh, fantastic. How'd that work?
Well, I just felt like I really needed to release a lot of stuff, because I do a lot of planetary holding of the space, so to speak. And I really needed to release, because the energies are so intense right now.
Oh, yeah. I mean, absolutely. With all the stuff that's going on, we certainly live in incredible times, either on the cusp of something brilliant or could be the exact opposite. And I'm certainly going for the brilliant aspect of things.
Definitely.
Now, obviously, you've been doing work for years. I mean, you're certainly a legend in many fields and genres that you touch. And I'm hoping that for those that maybe haven't heard of you before, because we reach such a wide variety of people, all of them are very well educated and astute listeners. But tell them a little bit about yourself, just a quick description, and we'll segue from there, please.
Well, do you want me to go back or just current?
Well, I mean, if we could go, I know that you had a car accident many years ago that kind of turned a switch on for you, didn't it? It was really a big, okay, maybe we could start from there.
Okay. I was coming back from work on a Saturday afternoon, and I was warned three times and I didn't listen to my guidance, and I had a horrible car accident. And what it ended up causing me to do is just sit in bed. I was in so much pain, had an extensive amount of injuries and soft tissue damage. Basically, you know, head to toe. I had a concussion. I had dislocations all over the place. I had sprained back and messed up vertebrae, and my neck was completely foobarred, and I completely shattered my foot. And so, you know, mobility was not an option. Let's just put it that way. So I laid on my back, freaking out, just, you know, because I've always been somebody who's, I've always got something to do, basically.
Right.
I think people know that about me. And I'm lying on my back, and I said, oh my God, why is this happening? What is this about? And I knew this was just so prolific, you know, that just the way it happened, the manner in which it happened. And that experience alone, it not only taught me how to love my pain, which sounds crazy, it caused me to go down a path of amazing alternative healing modalities and therapies, which now I'm thoroughly involved in because I saw the results. I'm truly someone who can come from testimony with that which I use on others. And I felt very, very married to that concept. I wanted to be somebody who could say, I use this, I know this works. I was very aware of the healing that's needed on the planet. And what happened was, lying in bed, started getting a ton of information. And the information basically was showing me the direction in which I'm going to be going. And the main thing was, a very massive project was presented to me that I was supposed to be spearheading. And we're kind of working towards that, frankly, Rex, okay, because it's that massive and it requires a substantial amount of funding. But it's been just following the cookie crumbs. You know, not everything is always totally visible right up front. It's really a journey. It taught me to be a lot more patient. And absolutely, I got just so in bliss with my connection with Source, and a lot of guidance. I had some incredibly wild experiences while I was in bed too. So
now, did you have a near death experience as well? Did you go to the other side or anything like that when you got into that accident?
I know I died, but I don't remember it. I know that sounds crazy, but I know I died, but when I came to, I wasn't out for that long a period of time.
Okay.
But I knew I had too much to do. And this was all part of, you know, from what I've received now, this was all part of getting me back on track. It was kind of like a wake up call, you know, and boy, did it wake me up in a big way.
A quick, that was more than a slap in the face. I mean, that was break all your, my goodness. I mean, it was funny you said that, because I was actually thinking when you were talking about that, and my gut was telling me that was universe kind of pushing you back into your, you know, specific orbit that you need to be in to create whatever it was that you were designed for. I don't know. I mean, that's just kind of what came into my mind when you were talking about that. And then you just said that afterwards. That's incredible. So it's actually made
you hit it right on the head. That's exactly why. I mean, I spent a little bit of time. I'm not someone who remained in victimhood at all. In fact, I used to blow people away because I was averaging 7 doctor's appointments a week. And everything from a neurologist, because my head, I had significant head injury, and, you know, everything from chiropractor to neurologist to, you know, you name it. I mean, it was just across the board. And everybody, the doctors were saying to me, how are you maintaining? We can't believe the amount of pain you're in. How are you getting through this? And I said, because I know there's a purpose. And when I would sit in the waiting room for my appointment, and I saw all these really crippled and hurt people, you know, obviously sitting in the waiting room with me, I would take that time to inspire them and try to help them. So
that's
incredible. I actually saw that as part of my journey.
Well, yeah. I've often heard, if you have a purpose, whatever obstacles present themselves in your life, just knowing that you have a purpose and you're following that path, you can get through anything. And certainly you're living proof of that. I think that that's incredible and outstanding. And one of the things that I wanted to bring up is, here at the Leak Project, as I mentioned at the beginning, we have so many different listeners that have certain spiritual beliefs, religious beliefs. You know, I mean, I talked to so many great people everywhere from, you know, Paul Beegley, where he's a really nice Christian person that has many followers as far as the work that he does and the teachings with the Bible. And then I talked to people that are on the opposite side of the spectrum where they either don't have any religious beliefs. Some I've talked to people that are atheists and agnostics and Gnostics and truth seekers and people that study hermetics. And with all of that said, the reason I'm bringing this up is because sometimes I read comments from people when I interview others that don't have the same religious beliefs, and they'll come out attacking them or saying that they're satanic or witchcraft or it's new age, when a lot of times, from the research that I've done anyway, these alternative fields of health, energy work, some of the work that you do and others that call new age and fringe.